Tell me why you think you'd be a good candidate for this research project.
Well, my sister was psychic, so I've seen how the side effects impacted her, and that's what really made me choose my major. And even though I'm learning a lot from my classes, I think this hands-on experience would be a great opportunity to better understand not only what she went through, but others as well.
Mind if I ask, what does your sister do now? Is she in school?
No.
Where does she work? What does she do?
She's been in a psychiatric institution since she was 14.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Do you or anyone else in your family have psychic abilities?
No.
Okay. Do you think the side effects of the citronin drug contributed to your sister's issues in any way?
I think a little. I mean, she was already... That's what I'm hoping to learn more of by working on this study.
Okay, nice. So do you think
that... Is it a problem that I'm not psychic?
Well, I was just about to ask you that. Would you feel comfortable working with our participants? Granted, our department's primary focus is on passive abilities, which includes, like, disguising and mind reading, for example. But the participants still had to sign an agreement to not use their powers in any way when meeting with the assistants.
Really, your job will be administering the trial medication and recording data, which just means a lot of paper and computer work. Despite that, do you think you'd still have any concerns about your safety?
No, I think I'd be okay.
I'm just used to it from growing up with Micah.
Okay, let's see. What ability did she have?
Premonitions.
Yeah, me too. Fun fact, that's another passive ability.
Really?
Yep. Tends to make handshakes awkward, though.
Yeah. It was like that for me too sometimes.
Well, Rowen, thanks for coming in.
So it's $20 an hour and part-time. Anywhere between 15 to 20 hours per week is expected, but you can certainly work more if you want to.
Great, yeah. My course load is pretty light this semester, so it's all good.
Excellent. Oh yeah, do you have a car, or how do you usually get around?
I just bike or take the bus.
That's fine. All the participants live in town, so you can bike to make all your deliveries.
Perfect. Sounds good. Thank you.
No, I can't.
Oh, right. Forgot. Sorry.
Right.
Bye, Jeremy.
See you, Rowan.
Congratulations. When do you start?
Monday.
And you're not scared of being mind controlled or getting teleported off to Antarctica?
Yeah, I can't wait. At least I wouldn't have to take that calc mental next week. So where are you going?
Lunch date. Not usually my thing, but he was all nervous and sweet when he asked, so I figured I'd cut him some slack.
Sounds adorable.
Oh, yeah. Super adorable. Anyways, when are we going to start double dating?
I'm working on it.
Okay. Well, damn, girl, work faster. Stop being so shy every time you go out. Just get buzzed enough to boost your confidence, but not to the point where you're sloppy. And start making out with someone.
Thanks, Dr. Phil. So, why are you leaving anyway?
Let's see. In 3, 2, 1.
Oh, shit!
See? He's adorable and he teleports.
Hi, I'm Sam. You ready?
Whenever you are. Oh, by the way, Ro, you got a letter in the mail. Looks like it's from your mom.
Oh. Okay. Thanks. Don't go to Antarctica.
Dear Rowan, Micah sent this to me 2 months ago asking to mail it, so it'll arrive today. I also gave her your new address so she can start writing to you on her own. I hope you'll come home one of these days for dinner. Dad, and I miss you. Love, Mom.
Rowan, I know I'm a little early, but I had to get all of this down before I forgot. Important. Congratulations on your new job. I have a good feeling about this research. I have a good feeling about what this research and what this medicine could mean for us psychics, and I'm so wanting to be a part of it. You'll do fine. Just...
All right, you're all set and now part of a research study funded by Sci-Lab. All the other lab rooms were taken, so we're actually going to be in here for the semester, but it's fine, no big deal. As you know, the Psychic Assimilation Act of 1992 requires all U.S. citizens who demonstrate psychic powers to take the medication known as citronin, which is meant to stabilize brain activity and hormones whenever they use their powers. Yet more than 15% of the people who take it suffer either mild to severe side effects. This includes headaches, nausea, heart palpitations. The purpose of this study is to test a new pharmaceutical drug meant to negate those side effects. Now, the most important thing to go over is the whole procedure of this research. You are each responsible for one patient. On Mondays, you will deliver your patients their prescriptions. On Wednesdays, you'll go through a survey on how they're responding to the medication. After that, you can come in whenever you want and update your database of their responses. Once a month, we'll have a sit down to discuss how things are going. Good luck.
Hi.
Hi. I'm Rowan. I'm your supervisor for the research study.
Right. Okay. Come on in. So, how does this thing work again?
Well, here are your pills. And, I just have to go through a survey with you before you start taking them.
Sure, that's cool.
Okay, what's your ability?
Disguiser.
And when did this start?
When I was about 6. You know we have a class together, right?
Which one?
History 15B. I've seen you around a couple times. Oh, this tastes like shit.
Wait, you're supposed to wait 2 hours before you eat something?
What?
Never mind. Wow. Thanks, Lori.
What?
Oh, nothing. Just my roommate ditching me for her apparating boyfriend.
Oh, that is so cool. And convenient. Oh, no, I don't mean the blowing you off part. I mean the teleporting part. I mean, that's gotta be more useful than talking to dead people all the time, right?
You talk to dead people?
Oh, no, not me. I don't talk to dead people. I'm talking about Aubrey Brennan. Here, you gotta listen to this. This is pretty sick. Week 3, and I've been having a lot of conversations with an old man named Benson who is still mourning the loss of his pet, Mr. Horny Corny. Wow. Apparently, his asshole brother thought he'd make a delicious family reunion dinner and stole him from the backyard. And he didn't tell he didn't tell Benson about Mr. Horny Corny until they were having dessert.
Wait, aren't we supposed to keep this stuff confidential?
We are?
I think so.
Mm. So what did your guy do?
Gets drunk with his friends and then pretends to be Chris Pratt so that he can hook up with sorority girls.
That is genius. You know, I can't believe they actually think that's a passive ability. I mean, the body has to physically transform for the disguise to work. I don't care what Dr. Caulfield says, it is not perception manipulation.
Who?
Dr. Caulfield? Harvard professor? Of Sykes and Men?
Lenny dies at the end, right?
Oh my god, who are you? You know, Dr. Caulfield believes that psychics should be able to participate in society without the use of citronin. In fact, he even believes that with this mandatory medication, it's gonna lead to total anarchy. Prepare to be mind blown.
If you think about it, there's been a major debate since like the 1950s. In fact, I think Dr. Caulfield talked about how just one group of psychics.
Oh, you should come talk to her.
What?
That's Aubrey, the chick who talks to dead people.
Okay, cool.
Come on, you were totally staring at her.
No. No, I wasn't. I just noticed her.
Yeah, sure you did.
Just like how I just noticed you Googling pictures of Michelle Rodriguez last week.
Okay, I'm kidding. But seriously, she's cool. Aubrey!
Aubrey!
Hey, Aubrey!
Good,
just chilling. How are you? Like, how are the drugs doing for you?
I managed to hold an hour-long conversation with some French skater dude without wanting to puke everywhere after.
Oh, good to know. Yeah, this is my coworker, Rowen.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks. Nice to meet you, too.
So, you got a minute? You want to sit and hang out with us for a bit?
Thanks, but I'm meeting my friends over at Froyo to go. But I'll catch up with you guys some other time.
Are you sure? We're tons of fun. Rowen here tells the greatest jokes.
Well, I hate to miss out, but I already promised them.
See you next week, though. And maybe you too, Rowen?
All right. Well, see you around.
See ya.
I think that went well. You're welcome.
It was great to read your last letter, Ro. I still can't believe you're in college. I know this is gonna sound random, but we should go traveling together one day. Just the two of us. Paris would be awesome, right? Looking up at the Eiffel Tower, crossing the city bridges. I don't know why, but I can see you there. I don't know if it was a vision or not. Are you planning to study abroad soon? If you are, send me postcards. Hope you're still enjoying the new job and keep me posted on everything. Love you lots. Micah.
How was the rest of your week?
The headaches are getting better, but the nausea still sucks.
Okay, so on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate your nausea?
11.
Well, how often have you used your ability since we last met?
Maybe 2 or 3 times. Me and my buddies have been dicking around a lot lately.
Still though, if you're only wearing these disguises for up to 30 seconds, you shouldn't be feeling that bad.
Do you take a pill every day like it says to?
Maybe 1 or 2 times a week.
Seriously, dude?
I know, I just keep forgetting and I'm more used to taking the other pill than this one. Sorry. Could you please write that in your report thingy?
Sorry, I can't do that. All of the information is important to the research.
No, I get that. But they're paying me for every day that I participate and take the pill, and I kinda owe some money this week that I need to pay off.
Just
this one time, I promise.
Fine. Just this one time.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you so much, Rowen.
No problem. Let's just finish this up.
Yeah. Fire away.
Here you go.
What am I supposed to do with this?
What do you think?
What? No. 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 No.
Come on. What says I like you more than free drugs?
She's gonna think I'm stalking her.
No, she won't. Just tell her I got a flat tire or something and you're just covering for me. Cool?
I'm just gonna get some tea. Do you want anything?
No, thanks. I'm good. So, how often have you used your abilities since last week?
Once or twice. I keep getting a lot of old people wanting to talk to me lately.
You can't control it?
I mean, I can, but I still get a few surprise visitors every now and then.
Okay, on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate your headaches after taking Zytrona?
Wow, you're so much more by the books than Dom. Right about now, he'd be going off on one of his Dr. Caulfield rants.
Yeah.
Come on, ask me a real question.
I don't...
Okay, I'll go first. What's your favorite kind of cereal?
What? Apple Jacks. What about you?
Lucky Charms.
Okay, I do have a question. When was the first time you started having your powers?
When I was about 7.
And?
It's kind of cliched. It happened after I saw The Sixth Sense.
No.
No lies. My brother and his girlfriend were watching it together, and I sat on the stairs and watched it with them. After the movie was over, I go back to my room and there's this boy sitting on my bed.
No.
Yeah. It was a boy who'd been kidnapped in San Francisco. Lots of therapy after that until the doctors realized what was really going on. Okay, my turn. Have you ever dated a psychic?
Yes, unfortunately.
Unfortunately?
8th grade for about 10 minutes.
What happened?
There was this boy in my class who all the girls were in love with, of course, and one day he asked me to meet him behind the mobile classrooms, and I did, and we kissed.
And
he turned out to be George Simpson from my homeroom.
George wasn't the preteen dream.
He always had these hot Cheetos stuck in his braces, and then they got on my upper lip too, and it was gross.
Now that's traumatic.
Yeah, one of the many reasons I swore off boys and hot Cheetos.
Now don't blame the Cheetos.
Let's change topics.
Well, it's your turn to ask something. And, I kept sliding down while the cardboard didn't, and I had scrapes all down my right side the next morning.
Oh god, I hated that class. And the textbook was totally useless.
So we snuck in with this huge bottle of peach vodka and took shots every time she said, Edward.
And she fell asleep with the bowl in her lap and Doritos stuck in her hair. Oh, I think I have a picture of it somewhere.
What?
I have to go. I have a study group coming in. Coming up. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Oh, yeah. You should probably get going.
I gave you your pills, right? Okay, I think that's everything.
Well, let me get your number. We can go out sometime.
What, like a date or something? Yeah, that'd be... That's cool. I'll see you around.
See? Told you we had a class together.
Yeah, no kidding. How are you?
Can't complain. It's been a good day so far.
How are the meds looking for you?
I haven't taken any medication today. Not even the citronin.
Wait, what?
Oh, but don't worry. I'll take them later, though. You know, I just haven't felt this good in a while. Hey, do you want to get a drink or something?
Oh, I actually have to get to the lab pretty soon.
Oh, it's just for a second, you know. It'd be my treat.
Sure, yeah, why not?
Cool.
Thanks again.
Yeah, no problem. See? Taking my medication as prescribed.
So, you're gonna join the cult?
This? Nah. I mean, I might check it out later, though.
Aren't they a little extreme?
Maybe, I guess, but they're not totally wrong what they're saying.
Well, I'm gonna head out. I'll see you next Monday.
Yeah, sure.
I swear, I'll be really careful with it.
Lori.
Please, it's just for tonight.
And you have to admit, it matches my romper perfectly. But my
just this once, and I will do everything in my power to make sure you look super hot for your date. Please. Please, 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 please.
Okay, just give it back after.
I will. I won't take it off a single time. Hey, it might be the only thing I end up wearing tonight.
Lori! I can't know that.
Oh, did I tell you how we were back at his place and he did that one thing with his...
Ew! No! Get out!
See ya.
Yeah, see you.
What time is it?
It's after 10 and I'm making breakfast, so get up. You okay?
Fine, just tired.
What time did you go to bed last night?
I don't even know.
You want me to go pick something up? I have some time before I go to the park with Sam. It's not a big deal. I can just go to Safeway. Shit. Bro, what's going on?
your parents?
No.
Well, do you need me to take you to the ER?
No. No, I'm fine.
Sorry. I thought I was feeling sick, but I'm okay now.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Aren't you supposed to have dinner before dessert? The place was too crowded, and I've been seriously craving some peach lychee lately. So, I basically told you my life story last week. What about yours?
There's not much to tell. Just mom, dad, that kind of stuff.
No brothers or sisters?
I have a sister, Micah. I don't really see her much, though.
Why?
She's in a mental hospital.
Wow. Really? Can I ask why?
She started getting visions really early, so my parents thought it would be best for her to be in a controlled environment.
Okay. That's good. Do you get to visit her a lot?
No, but she writes, so I know she's fine.
You don't go visit her.
Well, I mean, when I was young, my mom would never drive me up there, so.
No, I get it. It happens. Just asking.
No, I mean, it's a good question. I mean, I'm an adult now, so I can go up there and see her if I want to.
Well, there you go. A little rebellion never hurt anyone. Except, you know, the person being rebelled against.
That was lame.
Girl,
excuse me, ladies. Take a moment for psychic rights.
Yeah, but I don't want a flyer, thanks.
Did you know that several politicians are pushing to pass a bill that require psychics to have some sort of branding or ID to distinguish them from non-psychics? This bill would also prevent them from receiving certain healthcare benefits in the workplace.
Oh, okay. Well, we have to get going.
Well, would you join the mailing list for a donation online and receive invitations to our monthly meetings?
It's not that I don't care about psychic rights, it's just that I've heard those PT guys are more like a cult.
So you don't agree with having to take the Citronin pill?
I don't know. I've never really thought about it. I've taken it so long.
You know, there's this article about the psychic act that says it could lead to anarchy, like an implosion or something.
I guess I wish it wasn't the law to have to take a stupid pill every day for the rest of my life, but I have pretty good control over my powers, so.
Was it ever hard to control?
Kind of. At first, I couldn't, so my parents just thought I had too many imaginary friends, but the pill helped some, so I wasn't seeing ghosts pop up everywhere, but now I feel like I'm better off without it. Do you ever wish you were psychic?
No way. I didn't mean it like that.
No, it's okay. It's just, I think you're the first person I've ever met who doesn't think being psychic is the coolest thing ever.
Yeah? Is that a good thing?
Definitely.
I'm Monica, and I'm calling from the dean's office to schedule an appointment for you to come in and speak with me. We received a report of psychic activity coming from your apartment and need to discuss the situation with you as soon as possible. You can call me back at this number. Thank you.
That's not possible.
Well, I'm afraid it is possible, Miss Guy. This report was sent to our office just last week.
But how? I don't understand.
As you know, the government satellite picked up spiking levels of brainwave activity coming from your address. From there, we were sent to Yellow Alert, which is very lucky for you. At least there wasn't a police investigation. The bigger issue is that you didn't indicate you were psychic in your college application, which is considered falsifying information.
But I'm not psychic.
Well, according to this report and your family history, you are. At this point, Ms. Guy, I can only offer you two options. You could be dismissed from the university, or we could put you on the government-mandated medication, Citrulline. The school insurance will cover it. We'll update your records, and you can continue your studies. But you will have to meet with a physician every week, so we can make sure you're taking the medication as instructed.
But I'm not psychic.
Miss Guy, what do you want to do?
Hey, Ro. I'm guessing you just got back from the dean's office and you've more or less found out the truth by now. I'm so sorry I didn't tell you. I wasn't even sure myself that my visions were right about this, which it gave me some hope that I was wrong. The necklace wasn't supposed to protect you from other psychics. It was to suppress your psychic powers. I found out just before I left home, and I got scared. Scared of what it could mean for you, because I felt that something bad was coming. It's not going to get any easier after this. The voices are going to hit you hard until you learn to control it. I wish there was something I could do for you. It's gonna be okay, though. Honestly, I don't know what happens next. This is the last vision I had for you. But if there's anything else I can do for you, just write and tell me. Love you always, Micah.
You're late. Not even 10 minutes, man. So, I talked to your guy. He said you were the one to talk to about PT.
That's right.
So I went in.
Of course you want in. But what I want to know is what you're willing to do to get in.
Well, what do you want me to do? Wait, what do you need me to?
So, yeah, that's what happened.
Wow. That's a lot to go through in just a few days, huh?
Tell me about it.
Look, Rowen, thanks for letting me know, but you're fine. Being psychic doesn't mean you can't keep working with us. I mean, look at me. Just don't be surprised if we need to dissect your brain at some point.
Funny.
Yes, I am. Anyway, you guys need to hurry up and make your deliveries. So, I'll see you later.
I have so many questions for you. You're just now learning about your abilities. How can you control them yet? How have you been able to suppress them all this time?
I don't even know, okay? I'm still trying to process all of this, yeah?
Right. Sorry. But do your parents know? What's your prescription dosage right now? Did you know that there are some cases of psychics who never learn to use their abilities? Right. So
sorry.
And have you taken the medications once every day, like prescribed?
Yep.
Okay, great. That's everything. There's your new set of pills.
Well, you definitely had me fooled.
It's not like that.
It's like what?
I'm not. I mean, I wasn't. Well, I didn't think I was.
Well, do you take your pills every day as prescribed?
Seriously? And you were the one nagging me if I'm not taking my meds.
It's not the same thing. I don't need to take anything because I'm not psychic.
Just admit it. You hate the idea of having to take a single pill every day for the rest of your life.
So, how does it feel to be one of the skinny pigs now?
I'm so sorry.
It's cool. Don't worry about it. Actually, here.
No thanks. I don't need one.
Are you sure?
Yeah, Wait, no, how did you...
Just like you, Rowen.
How do you know my name?
I found your school files. We should probably mind speak. Keep things private.
Mind speak?
You don't know how to mind speak?
No.
Just concentrate on what you have to say. I'll pick it up.
You know what? I really have to get going.
You're one of us, Rowen.
Look, I know that, okay? What do you want from me? Jeez. Seriously?
And there'll be tacos. It's tomorrow. See ya.
So I was thinking, we could hang out at the cafe tonight. Start working on you getting control of your new powers, whatever they are. Plus, I really want to try their new mac and cheese order.
What?
Cafe, you, me, psychic powers.
Today. I can't today.
What? How come?
I have to clean with Lori tonight.
You can vacuum later. Do you not know what's at stake here? Your psychic powers. We need to start improving their control, like, now.
True, but she would kill me. She would kill me. What are you doing tomorrow?
I got a midterm on Monday. I can't go tomorrow. It's OChem. I have to study all weekend.
After Monday. I'll see you after Monday.
Mac and cheese. Yay.
Hey, Rowen, you made it.
Yeah.
Over here, I set up a spot for us.
But I never said I was coming.
I had a feeling.
I'd say it's time for you to learn how to mind speak.
You said I just need to concentrate on what I want to say.
Yeah, but that's only part of it. You're not sending your thoughts, just making them heard. To send something intentionally, it would take a lot more practice. It took me until my senior year of high school to figure it out.
How did you get better?
I had a mentor. It made a big difference. Now close your eyes, and again, focus on what you want to say. Make it as clear as you can. Once the words are clear in your mind, give them sort of a push. Find the link to my mind and direct them there.
So, like this.
Don't worry about it. That was really good, especially for your first try.
Thanks.
Ready to try again?
Yeah.
Tacos are here.
Rowen! No way, what are you doing here?
Just checking things out.
Yeah, Lori told me what happened. That's so insane, right?
Yeah, it's been a lot.
Good. I mean, I can't imagine going my whole life. Anyway, how'd you find our meeting spot?
That guy.
Figures. More than half our members are here because Sahil harassed them into joining.
Yeah, I'm kind of gifted like that. So, who was in the kitchen? Josh or Miguel?
Josh, which made it easier for me and Paige to get everything.
Josh's sauce isn't as good as Miguel's.
Well, you could have Paige convince him to do a better job.
You're kidding me. It's hard enough to get anything through his thick skull. He almost gave us extra chicken even after I told him carne asada.
On top of that, you had to take your pill today, which might have thrown you off.
Not like I had a choice, Sam. I had a midterm today, and you know they make us take that shit before we go in.
Whoa, dude, relax. I'm not blaming you. We're all trying to get around the same system.
Yeah, I get it. But you could always make it up to me by telling me you're a pretty princess.
I'm a pretty princess. Seriously?
That's what you get.
Oh, I hate you.
And yet you love me.
Let's just get this meeting started.
Out of all of us, Paige has the best control of her powers. Do not get on her bad side.
Guys, this is Rowen. She's our newest guest, and she can,
mind reading?
Very cool. Rowen and Sahil are only mind readers. I figure a welcoming gift is in order. Here you go.
Whoa. Thanks.
And don't tell Lori about this. She's been trying to get me to take her to Spain. Not gonna lie, I kind of borrowed it, but it's a thought that counts, right? Yeah. Sean, you're late. Again.
Sorry.
So, guys, how has your week been?
Time for our own research project.
What?
Rowen! Come on, how do you not understand how important this is? You're just now learning how to use your powers. I mean, wait, what can you do?
Mind reading.
Wait, seriously? Oh, that's so cool. Okay, what can you hear right now?
Nothing. I wear this and it kind of blocks the sound out. My sister gave it to me. It helps me block out my abilities or whatever.
Interesting. All right, let's try something. Give me the necklace, hand it over. Relax, it'll only be for a second. Okay, what can you hear now?
Something about third grade, you were bullied, she gave you wedgies and put worms in your lunch.
Okay, we get it. We get it, yeah, I got bullied by a girl, okay. The official term is telepathic perception. How cool is that?
Great.
Really, Rowen?
What do you want me to say?
Gee, I don't know. How about... Wow, Dom. I'm a miner. Maybe you could help me learn to control my powers? But of course. I would love to help you learn to control your abilities.
Gee, God, would you really?
I mean, after all, what are friends for?
First of all, I don't sound like that. And nobody says golly anymore.
I know, right? But, seriously, what's going on with you?
Look, I don't want to end up like my sister.
Your sister?
You told me about her once. She's in a hospital, right?
Yeah, my parents couldn't handle one psychic in the family. Imagine how they're gonna react to two.
Bro, that's not...
You wanna know why they sent her? My mom and Micah got into an argument one morning. Something stupid. And Micah, you know, her medicine and the strain of her visions, and they're fighting, and my mom is yelling at her, and then Micah finally looks up at her and says, "Mom, you should really be nicer to me, because I know how you're going to die." And they cart her away to an insane asylum. And then we pretend like she doesn't exist, and they never let me see her again. So, sorry if I'm not excited about being a mind reader.
Look, Ro. At least let me help you figure this all out.
Look, Dom, I really...
And if I can't, then I'll leave you alone so you can mope to your heart's content, okay?
Okay. Fine.
Perfect. Bye. Perfect. Okay, we'll start first thing tomorrow morning, alright? Like, I'm feeling the whole Mr. Miyagi thing going for me right now. Or you could call me Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obi-Wan could have handled Stacy Green.
Hey, don't judge me! She was vicious!
I'm sorry, I was just, you know, worried about you. Like, I thought you were gonna join some kind of a cult, which apparently you did.
I did not.
But that's the PT Flyer guy right over there.
His name's Sahil.
You're on a first name basis with the PT Flyer guy?
The guy is helping me control my powers, okay? Look, it's been 2 weeks, and I can block other people's thoughts out. Sahil's a little weird, but he's a good guy. You can even sit in on the meeting if you want.
Thanks, I think I will.
Look, just promise me you're not gonna go off talking about Caulfield, okay? No politics, no
I
Caulfield.
Don't only talk about Dr. Caulfield.
Yeah, you do.
No, I don't.
Hey, Rowen, good to see you.
This is my friend, Dominic.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Hey, don't mind me. I'm just a friendly observer here to take notes and whatnot.
So far, we've been focusing on mind-speaking, but let's try something a little trickier. Remember when I showed you how to find our meeting place? Mm-hmm. Well, it's kind of like mind-speaking, but it requires more concentration to send clear images. The first thing to do is clear your mind. Now, give me your hands.
Do I have to hold your hands?
Usually when we're just starting out in telepathic communication, it helps to make physical contact because it kind of tricks your brain into thinking that there's a connection when there isn't any. But don't worry, I'm not trying to make Aubrey jealous.
Great.
The first step to learning a new skill is going back to basics. So deep breaths, in and out.
Bad. Sorry. My bad.
Something.
What?
High five for not only scoring a date, but a hot date at that.
Can we not?
Come on.
Hey, there you are.
Hey, guys. What's up?
Not much.
Good. Yeah, I'll see you guys later then.
There's something on your shirt.
Oh, must have been from lunch.
Whatever. Catch you later.
Sean? John! I don't believe this. Asshole. Hey, Jeremy, can I ask you? Jeremy? I know what I saw, Dom. It was Jeremy, covered in blood.
But we barely just saw Jeremy 2 hours ago.
Then whoever we saw wasn't him. Maybe it was someone in disguise.
Well, maybe the body you found was someone disguised as Jeremy.
Look, I don't know what to think. All I can say is we were talking to Jeremy 1 minute, and then I find his body the next.
Well, there is one way we can be sure.
This is your idea of a third date, Ro? I gotta admit, threesomes aren't really my thing.
Whoa! Dude, TMI what? Much?
No, no! Fuck, we just really need your help with something.
You know our boss, right?
Yeah, sure.
We think something happened to him. We were wondering if you could reach him with your abilities.
But I don't... Wait, he's dead? Okay, let me see what I can do. Jeremy? Jeremy, are you there? Can you tell us what happened to you? Who did this to you?
I think... I did.
So it was someone disguised as you?
It had to be.
But who? And why?
No idea. It was like looking in a mirror, except for the vision I got from this guy.
What'd you see?
I told you I could do it. You didn't say anything about the files!
What files?
The files that are back in the lab with my body.
What about them?
I found some data a few days ago. A bunch of chemical formulas that are designed to a new kind of drug. A suppressant, I think. It's stronger than citronin and meant to shut down the part of the brain that's active when someone's using their abilities.
Jeez.
Scilab was keeping this as secretive as possible for a reason. And if someone was willing to kill me for it...
It's definitely not a good thing.
Jeremy? Jeremy!
Get her water or something!
Are you okay?
Yeah. Never
done that for so long before.
Are you sure you're okay?
No.
Guys, listen to this. Dear students and staff members, due to internal maintenance, the Sci-Lab building will be closed until further notice. During this time, no one except authorized personnel is allowed inside. Meanwhile, all meetings and research studies will be suspended. Any trespassers will be persecuted to the fullest extent.
Is this for real? You think they found Jeremy? Of course they have. All right.
All right? All right, what?
All right, we get those files.
I'm kidding.
You heard what Jeremy said? The killer wants those files to make the stupid drug or whatever. You said it yourself, Dom, right? That's not a good thing, right? Rowen, Jeremy just died. You really want to go back there? Yes. I can't just sit here and do nothing. If those files were important to Jeremy, then we should at least, I don't know, save them or something.
This ain't some Sherlock Holmes shit, Rowen. This is real life. We should let the police handle it.
The files will be gone by the time they get there. The killer will be back for those files too, Rowen. Not if I get there first.
Rowen, you're being stupid. Who cares about a bunch of papers? We shouldn't have to end up like Jeremy.
What's up, motherfuckers?
Come on, Lori, go to bed.
No, you go to bed.
Don't worry, I got her.
It's getting late. You guys should probably go home.
Yeah. You should get some rest, okay?
I will.
And by get some rest, I mean don't do anything stupid.
Well, we'll talk later, okay? I had to.
Working for the government to experiment of some kind? Give me a break.
So I guess that makes me a traitor too.
Yeah, I guess it does. But he told me he convinced you that it wasn't too late to help you.
He? Who's he?
Oh, my new friend.
Does your new friend also slit people's throats?
Well, I guess I'll have to ask him when I give him the folder, so...
Give me the fucking photo!
Well, who's that?
It was a serum from Jeremy.
A serum from Jeremy? How?
Well... you feeling any better?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Good. About Rowen, it's just, she just needs a little bit of time to think on it, you know, and like, she's just...
Oh!
Hey, Aubrey. Yo, are you okay? What's going on? Talk to me.
Dominic.
Jeremy, what are you doing here?
There's no time, just listen. Those files that I told you about, I have a backup of them on my cloud.
Okay, so?
You have to get them.
Okay, I'll get them, but you have to go. Aubrey, she's...
There's something else. A serum that I was holding for Professor Head. You have to get it and keep it secret until...
Are you okay? I should have known you were gonna do something stupid like this.
Yeah.
Even though your girlfriend said not to.
Sorry, I... Sam? What are you doing here?
Checking to see if Sean got the files I asked for. Apparently not.
You're the one who convinced him to kill Jeremy?
I didn't make him. I told him it was a necessary evil if he wanted to earn his way into PT.
You had our friend murdered so he could get into a fucking cult?
It's not a cult. It's a movement. Moving to a future where psychics don't have to worry about being oppressed by the likes of you. Or Lori. Where are government?
Lori, what did you do to Lori?
Don't worry, Rowen. She's sound asleep in her bed. I didn't want to kill her. You know, I wish I had your gift. To know what people are thinking at every moment, how they feel, instead of listening to empty platitudes. Tell me, what exactly are you thinking?
Thinking that if I ever get out of here, I'm gonna tell Lori she has shitty taste in guys.
I'm not going to kill you. I'd ask you to join PT Rowen on Sahil's behalf, but it doesn't seem like you're interested.
Sahil is in this?
Are you kidding? Sahil? He wants Utopia, but he's not willing to do whatever it takes to get it.
Well, you can tell him I'm sorry, that I'm not a twisted freak like you.
Oh, you're a freak, Rowen. Don't think for one second you're not. Society thinks so. Dominic thinks so. There's no telling what Lori's going to think when she finds out her psychic boyfriend drugged her and put her to sleep. The second you forget you're one of us, your parents are going to put you away just like they did your sister. Well, I think that's everything. But I'll see you guys around.
Man, fuck that guy. Hey, Rowen, snap out of it. We gotta get out of here.
Yeah, I know. Do you need another aspirin?
No, I'll be okay. I just feel so stupid. Of course he was too good to be true.
It's not your fault he turned out to be such a fuckboy.
A fuckboy is one thing, Ro. A psychotic murderer and a cult leader is another.
Yeah, good point.
Morning.
You want some water?
Yeah, that'd be nice. Hey, Lori. Sorry about your boyfriend.
Thanks, but I'll be okay. I'm just gonna have to refine my ice cream and Netflix strategy to get over this one.
Yeah. Can we talk in your room?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Sure.
I got something crazy to show you. Get the computer out. What's this?
Oh, it's a letter from Martha. I couldn't sleep last night, so I started writing it. I'm gonna ask her if I can come visit her.
Well, you weren't the only one who couldn't sleep last night. Check this out.
What is it?
It's from Jeremy.
How is that?
I logged into it and I found all these files. The first few are the ones that Sam took. But then there was others about PT and some legal documents that honestly I fell asleep before I could get through all of them. But it's not just formulas for a new drug. There's also a huge log of nearly every registered psychic here in California. Their names, addresses, social securities, everything.
And that's what Sam was after.
I think so. Maybe. Here, look at this. 10 other people all over the country were found dead about a week before Jeremy. And I did a little more digging, and it turns out that all of them were involved in research studies, all of which focused on new drugs for psychics.
So Jeremy wasn't the only target. So, wait, what did he do? Go around killing people in between classes?
That, or he had other PT members doing it, doing his dirty work, just like how he made Sean do it. But whether or not it was him, the point is, they're making a statement. Do you remember what he said? A small piece of
a bigger picture. What the hell is he gonna do with the list of psychics?
Probably recruit them to this so-called movement. I transferred everything onto here if you want to see it.